arrows. I'm Kashawn, and you are watching The Book Archer. She says, thank you for all of y'all's sweet comments the last time. Ain't that right, baby? She's not even paying attention. You don't want to talk to the people today? The last video I posted was for my Blackathon TBR. They're gonna go over all the books that I read for Blackathon, as well as the books I read in March. I know a lot more people have been watching YouTube during this time, but I have still been working like crazy. In fact, the only reason I have time to film today is because I took a day off of work. So let's go ahead and get into my February and March wrap up. The first book that I read in the month of February was A Song of Blood and Stone. This is a new adult romance fantasy, which I thought was really interesting, and I never had read anything in that genre by a Black author. In this world, they have two separate nations. One of the nations has magic and the other one doesn't. And a long time ago, they used to coexist, but of course, there was some big war. I think the people that didn't have magic were trying to steal the people's magic that had it. Towards the beginning of the story, she runs into this guy who is from the nation that doesn't have magic, but he's actually working as a double agent, as a spy. So the story kind of takes off from there. I really enjoyed this a lot more than I was expecting to. I think a lot of it had to do with it being a new adult romance fantasy, because you kind of got a lot of elements that I really like right now. I like that there was a journey aspect, and I like that Jasminda wasn't really someone who was like a chosen one. It was mentioned quite frequently that her magic was not that strong. And another thing I really like here is that this fantasy world had its own like ancient gods, and you kind of get to hear the stories from their perspective, and it eventually weaves into the current story. And on top of that, once you get to the end of this book, it feels like a complete story. There are like I think two or three other books that are in this series, but they follow different main characters, so they're kind of like companion novels, but you can read this one just on its own and you don't feel like you're left with any cliffhangers or anything like that. I listened to this on audiobook, which I did enjoy, but I also think this is one that would be really good in the physical copy as well as the audiobook. I gave this one a 3.75 out of 5 stars, and it was a great start to the reading month. The next book that I picked up was Slay by Brittney Morris. This book was really, really popular on BookTube last year. It was highly anticipated. It follows Kiara Johnson. She has created this online game called Slay, and basically Slay is this virtual like magical game, but it's steeped in Black culture. So a lot of the references and everything are Black culture related. There are different like cards that you can get to play the game. If you are a part of the gaming community or have ever played games, a lot of times on regular games, there is a lot of racism that kind of goes into the online gaming world. They just like drop the N-word and everything like that. Like crazy, people will talk to you crazy, and this game is supposed to be a haven where Black people can go and play and not feel those same prejudices that they feel when they play other games. So it has this huge underground following, but towards the beginning of the story, which this is in the synopsis, there's someone that gets killed in real life, and it kind of relates back to the game. So then her game starts to make national headlines, and the media starts to pick apart this game essentially racist, okay for this space to exist that's exclusively just for Black people. So you kind of see how she gets to navigate that, as well as some other personal issues that Kiara has going on. It's been almost 2 months and I'm still trying to unravel my feelings about this book, because the main thing that I absolutely loved about this book was the game and the different perspectives that we got to see of Black gamers. There are a lot of like minor characters to see how their experience is playing the game from like all over the world, and I absolutely love that because you just get to see so many different age ranges of people, so many different types of people, and just like their personal experiences and how it's all connected to the game. Plus, I found the game to be absolutely fascinating, and that is kind of the main vocal point of the story, so I essentially enjoyed that. However, there was I feel like towards the end of the book, everything got kind of rushed, and some things just didn't make sense to me. I just kind of found it hard to believe that literally nobody knew that she had about this game, like nobody. Nobody at all. So I just kind of thought that was very odd. I feel like so much of it got convenient for me. So I had to knock it down like a few stars for that. But I didn't hate it. And if Brittney Morris wrote another book, I would read it. I still recommend this one. I feel like there is not really another book out here like this by a Black author. So the next book that I read for Blackathon and in the month of February was actually my favorite read for the month. I'm so excited about this one because this one is surprisingly a middle grade. And this is by Brandy Colbert, Only Black Girls in Town. This was such a good middle grade. I really, really love this book. I got this ARC from Y'all Fest last November. I think the book is out now. It came out in March, I'm pretty sure. Let me double check so I can tell y'all the right thing. Yeah, so it came out in March. So basically it follows these two girls. One of them lives in this California, this small tight-knit California community. She's lived there for her entire life and she's very much a West Coast girl. She's very laid back. She loves to surf. She's the only Black girl in her town and she's always been the only Black girl until this family moves in like down the street from her, and then there is this other Black girl that shows up who's around her same age, but she's from like New York. She's really homesick. They have totally different types of vibes and energies. This is kind of shows like how they both become friends and kind of like navigate each other's spaces together. But then there's also like this underlying little mystery aspect. The house that the new girl from New York moves into used to be owned by someone who recently passed away, and they find all this stuff in the attic. They find these old journals and they're trying to figure out like whose journals are these. All the journals take place during like the civil rights movement and back in the day, and they document like a lot of different things. So it kind of turns into this fun mystery that they do. I love this book because I love the familial aspects of both of the families. There's one dynamic where one of the characters' parents just got divorced, so she's kind of trying to process that. But it also really felt like the issues and the things that they were going through made complete sense for their time. There was just such a fun innocence to it, but it also kept me really engaged because I was really invested. This is one of my new favorite middle grades. It makes me want to really pick up some of the other middle grades that I have on my shelf. So I would give this one a 4.5 out of 5 stars. All right, y'all. So the next book, this is so hard for me to do. Y'all already know I have been anticipating this sequel for over 2 years. I've talked about it a ton and I finally read it, The Deathless Divide, which is book 2 in the Dread Nation series. I guess it's called Dread Nation. I don't know. Book 1 was Dread Nation. Y'all know I loved it, gave it 5 stars. It was my favorite read of 2018. And this was so disappointing to me. Like, after reading this, I 100% feel like Dread Nation should have been a standalone, period. And after reading the author blurb at the end that Justina Ireland puts, it really does make me think that Dread Nation should have been a standalone, because a lot of the issues that I have with this could have just been resolved if they stopped at book 1. The main thing about this book is that it did not feel like it had any direction. It felt like Justina Ireland was just trying to figure out like, okay, well, the first book wrapped up, like, oh, what else can I do? It gave me vibes of like, you know, like a soap opera where they wrap up a storyline but then crazy stuff just keep happening and then other stuff just happening, and it's like, how does this relate back to the original plot? That's how I felt about this. For those who have not read Dread Nation, it basically takes place post-Civil War, except as if zombies existed, and the main character is a zombie fighter. So she goes around fighting zombies and she's supposed to be like the equivalent of a lady in waiting. But a bunch of stuff happens in the first book. Book 2 is supposed to pick up where that left off. And let me tell you, I honestly just felt like it was a mess. Like, the whole time I was reading it, I just kept thinking like, where is this leading to? So things kind of wrapped up at the end. Like, I don't even think there will be a book 3. There doesn't really need to be. But I was just so disappointed by this. Like, I'm actually kind of mad about it. The author blurb, Justina Ireland, says that she was trying to figure out where else to take the story, and that I guess she didn't anticipate the success that Dread Nation had. Okay, girl. I mean, it wasn't like a terrible book. I just don't see what the point of it was. And I had such high expectations that it just didn't even come close to what I thought it was gonna be. And overall, I probably give this like a 3 stars, but I don't think I'll ever read this again. I think I'll reread Dread Nation, but I'll keep this because the cover is pretty. But yeah, so disappointed about that. Those are all the books that I read in February and for Blackathon. I know in my Blackathon TBR video I said I was gonna be doing recommendations and vlogging and all this other stuff, but then I just did not feel satisfied with the amount of Black literature that I had consumed in order to give y'all recommendations. So those videos will still be coming in the future, but I just gotta read some more stuff so I can really recommend y'all like like some good stuff, not like the same books that y'all see all the time. I only read 2 books in March, but y'all, I really, really liked both of these books, so I'm so excited to talk about them. This book has been on my TBR for a little while and I finally picked it up, and that is The Last Magician by Lisa Maxwell. I really, really enjoyed this. It has time travel and magic in it. It takes place, I think, in like 1905, but basically towards the beginning of the 1900s, and it follows this main character who has to time travel back in time to stop something from happening with the last magician in order for it to like not have such a negative impact moving forward in the future. The things that I really liked about this book is it really just gave me a good sense of that era. I feel like Lisa Maxwell did a really great job because it takes place in New York City. It really gave me a mixture of vibes of like diviners, Six of Crows type of stuff. I really like how original it still felt, even though it was reminiscent of other stories that I really liked. It did feel like a journey. There were things that happened that you weren't expecting to happen. There were things that played out in that way that where you feel like there's suspense and tension. And also, I really feel like romance wasn't like a huge part. It didn't overtake the story or anything like that. There's kind of like a slow burn. I feel like all of the elements made sense. Everything came together and it didn't feel like the author was just doing stuff just to do it. So if you've been thinking about picking up this series, go ahead and do it. Like I said, the first 100 pages are really slow and it's just like, I don't understand why people like this. But then after that, it just takes straight off. So the very last book that I want to talk to y'all about is the third and the final book in the Truly Devious Mystery, YA Mystery Trilogy by Maureen Johnson, and that is The Hand on the Wall. Y'all, I love this trilogy with my whole heart. I am so glad that I decided to pick it up, and I have a newfound love for YA mystery. So I know thrillers and mysteries are really popular on BookTube, but I am not a thrillery mystery kind of girl because I don't do scary. You're not finna scare me. The real thing that I love, love, love about Maureen Johnson's novel is the majority of it is about a cold case. So this is something that happened in the 1930s, so it feels kind of far away and separate, and that made it much more enjoyable. I didn't have like this huge anxiety. Now, mind you, there is a current mystery that's kind of going on at the same time, but the bulk and the meat of the story is about this cold case that the main character is trying to find. It takes place at this boarding school in Vermont in the mountains, and oh my gosh, the setting and everything, it's just so scenic. I love all the characters in this story. Even the characters that I don't like, I still like them because I feel like they were so well written. Like, they feel like real people that I'm actually like, do I like this person? Do I not like this person? I think Maureen Johnson did a phenomenal job at writing this series. I feel like the ending was satisfying. The only requirements I have for a mystery novel is, did I see the ending coming? If I couldn't figure out the mystery, I'm happy. Even if I'm like, that's who it was? That's what happened? That's not what I was like, oh, okay, I thought it was gonna be something grander. No, as long as I didn't guess it. I just love this series so much. I'm gonna do a whole entire trilogy wrap up. I listened to all of these on audiobook. I highly suggest the audiobook. I love the audiobook for this series. I just felt like it was super atmospheric. The mystery was interesting. I loved the flashbacks. I loved how everything was woven together. I think that the only difference is it could have been a duology. It didn't necessarily need to be 3 books, but I just loved it. I loved it. I'm gonna buy the entire trilogy on hardback, but I highly, highly recommend the audio. Those are all the books that I read in February and March. What is everyone reading right now? Leave it down in the comments. I can't wait to chat with y'all. Have y'all read any of these books? Let's talk about them. Also, I'm doing a lot of recommendations videos soon, so leave what you want to see recommended down in the comment section below. I love y'all, and I will see y'all next time. Bye!